TipTut.
Hello everybody and welcome back to TipTut and welcome back to Intro to Adobe Animate. Wow, we did a lot last time. We did a bunch of frame by frame animation. I've tidied it up a bit. I've made him hang in the air less and drop a bit quicker. Still not totally happy with it. I removed some frames, added some frames in just to make it a little bit smoother. I think honestly he needs to drop a bit quicker and perhaps even remove this frame too and then use this one as a bit more of a blur between the two because I think his arc of motion isn't 100% correct, okay? So if we look at that, kick, land. That'll do, perfect, okay. So now, as someone in the comments mentioned last time, we're gonna animate his head because he doesn't have one, but he will soon. So let's just jump right into that. Fair warning, you'll probably hear my cat eating in the background. She's got a big tower full of food and she's decided that right now is the time that she's gonna start rattling that around in order to just generally just annoy me, I think. So yeah, apologies if you hear that. So what we're gonna do now is I'm just gonna outline this body and the head and get this neck lined up on the first frame. I'm gonna move the rotation point to bottom left-ish of his head just so that we get the right rotation when we twist this around. And I'm just basically just gonna go through and make sure that his head is aligned in each frame. Okay, so that first one looks pretty all right, looks well aligned. So now we'll just F6 and we'll move on, of course making sure that our onion skin is on as well at the same time. So moving along and rotating the head, making sure that we move it the amount that it would naturally move with the body, and making sure that our neck stays roughly in the same position and making sure the head doesn't move erratically compared to how the body is moving. So I'm just gonna fast forward and do this because it's exactly the same process as what we went through last time. So there's no point in making you sit through it again with the head because you've already done it for the body. So I'll see you on the other side. Now, as the eagle-eyed among you may have already noticed, I did also just readjust some of the body poses there. So that's absolutely a thing that is totally okay to do when you're animating. Just to go back and to readjust some poses and redraw things and move them around. There's nothing wrong with that at all. Luckily, his eye blinks kind of do link up. So as he goes for this jump here, let's just deselect that so we can see. His eyes do actually close. If we just remove that onion skin, it's easier to see. Okay, his eyes close as he leaps. And then as he goes to the top of his kick, they open up again. And just as they're falling, they do begin to close as he lands and opens up again as he does fall out of that land. Just a coincidence. Didn't plan that. It's a nice surprise. Okay, great. So that's the head moving then. We want to get into a bit of tweening now and combining motion tweening and frame by frame animation. And the way we're going to do that is with the shadow. Okay, so I'm just going to draw a circle with the circle tool over here. I'm going to get a nice dark gray. And I'm gonna do roughly the size of his feet, okay? Now, we're gonna right click on this and hit convert to symbol. And this time you want it to be a movie clip because we're not gonna have any animation inside of it, and movie clip gives you a bit better options when it comes to adding filters and blurs on symbols. We'll call this one shadow and hit enter. Oh, it's already taken because I'm doing this in the same project as the previous tutorial. Now we've got our shadow. It looks a bit blocky. If you like that style, go for it. That's no problem at all. If you want it to be a bit softer, I'm just going to rename this layer to shadow. If you want it to be a bit softer, then you need to apply a filter to it like I'm going to do now. So firstly, I'm just going to drag the shadow layer below the body because, well, that makes sense, doesn't it? And make sure that the blur doesn't really go any further than our floor line. Okay, so now with our symbol selected, I'm just going to go over to the properties panel. And under filters, which may or may not be hidden by the library, just hit the add button and we're gonna add a blur. Now you wouldn't get these options on a graphic, hence why we need a motion clip, movie clip for this particular element. Okay, so that looks okay, about 20 pixels blur. And under color effect, I'm just gonna come down to alpha and I'm gonna drop the opacity of it just a little bit. Okay, perfect. Now if we zoom out, there, that's not too overpowering. It looks about right. So we're gonna do some motion tweening then. So what we do in motion tweening is you choose the first position of your object, you choose the ending position of your object, and then you let the computer decide what the frames are going to be in between, and this saves you a bit of time. Okay, so we probably want our next keyframe to be as he finishes leaping, because you can see the movement from left to right kind of finishes there. Okay, so we're going to add in a new keyframe just before he leaps off on the shadow layer. And we're going to move the shadow to where it would naturally be. So, of course, his body is a bit more upright now, so it would be a bit shorter. And it would obviously be underneath him, not to the left. Okay, that's totally fine. Now we want a nice quick snap as he travels to his point of finishing, which is about, let's say, there before he starts to come down. Okay, so from there we want to move the shadow along, and because he's higher up the shadow wouldn't be quite as pronounced, so what we're going to do is select that and bring the opacity down to about 25. Okay, and now it's darker there and it's more see-through when it reaches the zenith of his arc of his jump, because he's further away from the floor. Okay, so then we want the next bit to be as he lands, probably this frame right here, because after that it's going to stretch out and be a bit wider again, because his body is stretching out and becoming wider. So we'll make it a little bit wider there. We'll bump the opacity back up to 50, okay? And then at the end of his fall, we want the shadow to be as long as he is, as long as he is, and directly underneath him, okay? So now if we play that back, you'll notice the shadow just jumps around. There's no animation, doesn't look good. That's because all we've done is put our keyframes in, and all these frames in between are just repeating the preceding keyframe, okay? So what you wanna do is select all those frames, right click on them and hit create classic tween, okay? Now what this will do is the computer will try to generate what it thinks you want on each of these frames. So although they don't have the dot in them, all of these now have movement. You can see that the shadow follows our character along. Not perfectly though, because we've added easing quite naturally in our frame by frame animation. So we're gonna have to add a bit of easing to this now. So if you look at our character, you notice that he moves quite quickly and then settles in. So the shadow needs to move quite quickly and then settle in as well. And the best way to do that is with easing. There is a tweening ease option under the tweening menu. If you click the pencil, you'll get a detailed graph similar to that that you use in After Effects. If you want it to be simple, however, ease out 100% means it goes from very fast to very slow. Negative 100 is easing in, which goes from very slow to very fast. So easing in, for example, if I just hide these so it doesn't get distracting, would go from slow to fast. And easing out, for example, at a positive figure of 100, goes from fast to slow, as opposed slow to fast, okay? Now, in this situation, we probably want fast to slow, because if we notice the way the character moves, fast to slow, right, I'm actually just gonna shift that back a bit. There we go, bam. And you know what, that probably moves for a little bit long. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate that keyframe there by holding Alt and dragging it, and then right click and remove this tween. Now, what that does is, the animation finishes a little bit earlier. It holds for a single frame and then it continues on the next one. Okay, that just gives it a bit of breathing room, makes it look a bit more natural. So I'll just put that underneath him, copy that because I've moved it, delete that there on the next keyframe and hit paste in place so that I know that I'm working from the same thing. This is the same as this. Okay, so his next one, he reaches that point and his zenith is pretty much okay. It's a bit slow at the start though. So we're gonna have this one ease out ever so slightly, but not 100%. Maybe let's try 50%, see if that catches him up. Maybe 60, yeah, that catches him up quite well. Let's see how that works. Bam, he's a little bit quick at the start and then follows him pretty well. So let's put that back to 50 and see how that looks. Yeah, that looks okay. The next bit is pretty much spot on. So I'm not going to bother adding any easing to that, because if you go back and forth, it looks pretty all right. But this one needs to go from slow to fast. Maybe, again, not 100%. Maybe let's try 50. No, it needs 100. Oops. But even so, that's still not quite enough. So there's two ways we can fix this. One, we can move our ending keyframe up a bit, which makes the whole animation slightly faster. Okay, that looks okay, but it doesn't look perfect because he is still moving on the last frame. Okay, so the second option is to go over here with our 100% easing to the pencil, and you'll notice that it's made a very smooth arc. So what we can do is take our origin and drag this handle up like so, and then take our ending point and drag this handle up like so to create a much more severe flick of an arc. Okay, now I probably don't want that one to be like that. Let's try it like that first of all. And let's see how that looks. Looks a bit better, but it still ends a bit late. So what we'll do is we'll grab this point of origin here. So we've got, sorry, our starting point and our finishing point. So let's just move that out a bit. That looks okay. So we've edited that there. So now if we go back here, you'll notice it's got a dash. That's because it's not a straight ease. It's now had custom values applied to it within the pencil. And we will just shift this forward by about 2 frames because there's not really much difference between that frame and that frame. But that will affect the overall shadow. Bam, there we go. Perfect. All right, maybe 1 or 2 more. Bam, yeah, there we go. Look at that. Okay, so now let's look back at this. Perfect. We like it. Well, not perfect, but it'll do. So now we've animated the head and we've animated the shadow. I'm going to leave it till next time to move on to the effects because we're getting close. I did actually time lapse earlier, so this might be a bit of a short episode. I'm sorry if it is. But what you can do is use all the techniques that we've applied this time around to introduce a second stick man, if you'd like, if you need something to do between now and next episode. Otherwise, next time we will get on to the fun bit, doing the effects, which is some really nice frame by frame painting animation. Okay, so hopefully you'll stick around and I'll see you all next time.
Remember to subscribe for more tips, tricks, and tutorials. Thanks for watching.